Shooter ready.
Ready.
Go.
Hi guys, today we'll talk about a little bit of the field craft. You have been asking me what is this magical shooting sock, and more important, how to do it. Well, the shooting sock is very, very useful, especially when you need an extra support for your magazine to the ground. So instead of putting on the ground, I always use the shooting sock, and it gives you a better support than the ground, especially if you have a soft ground, like maybe, you know, a little bit after the rain, and the magazines will have a tendency to sink into the ground. So the shooting sock works extremely well in the conditions like this. The same goes for the winter time. If you wanna, you know, put it on the snow, the shooting sock helps to keep that magazine higher, you know, to the ground. And if you are wearing a body armor, you need even more distance from the ground to have a better support, and the shooting sock again could be used in that situation as well. So as you can see, there are many uses for the shooting sock, and it's something very simple to make. You know, all my friends, all snipers, they are running with even two or three shooting socks. I'm not that crazy. One is good enough for me. So how to make one, and look at this, you can even use as extra storage for the rounds if you want to. But how to make one? Well, first go to the Walmart and get some airsoft BBs. Yeah, airsoft is finally being useful. Nothing against the airsoft guys, I know we got a lot of airsoft fans, but I have found that these airsoft BBs are perfect. The reason for it is because they are synthetic, and they are not getting wet. They cannot get destroyed by the nature elements. So you will need this, and this jar will cost you with tax around $15, a little bit over $15. So that's not bad. Then you need extra, you know, old used socks. Hopefully you have the army socks like those, man. Okay, we don't need that one, we just only need one. And if you got those army socks, they are perfect for this job, because they are long and they have this very long extension which goes and drives me nuts. That's why I don't wear them under uniform, but they are very tall and they go right up to the knee. But why is this useful? Look at this, guys. Now all you gotta do is wrap it around the jar like that. Okay, make sure everything is sealed off. Now you just flip that jar, hold on to the sock, and voila, all the BBs are in the sock right now. Okay, so we are very close of getting the shooting sock done. Now milk it a little bit. You boys, you know what I'm talking about. Don't get any stupid ideas. Milk it, twist it, okay, and you can bounce it back. You know, how much BBs should go into the sock? I like them all full, but some guys, they just use the half, you know, half length of the sock. So it depends what you want to do with it, but milk it a little bit, shake it if you have to, okay, kiss it, embrace it, love it, because you're going to use that shooting sock a lot, okay. And basically tight the knot. Just one is good enough. There's nothing special to it. There you go. So you tighten the knot, make sure it's sitting really tight. Okay. So now that sock would look weird like this. So what we're going to do is we're going to flip it inside out, that extra what we got of the material. So it's going to look nice, and hopefully the sock will cooperate with me. There you go. Look at that. Ooh, it's looking beautiful. There you go, guys. And this is your little shooting sock. That's how it is done. Spread the BBs evenly. Okay, and this is your new shooting sock. So some, as I said, some of the guys, they have two. They stack them together, or they put one up front for the better support of the rifle up front, and then one on the back. You can use them any way you want it, but this is a little bit of the Fieldcraft. This is how the shooting sock is done. Let me know if you have any questions. I hope I was clear enough how to make them, okay? That's it, guys. Thanks for watching.
Ready? Go!